Hello, in this video you will learn how to analyze asymmetrical portal frame which is subjected to sway using Carney's method. Carney's method is also known as rotation contribution method. When the frame is asymmetrical due to any reason, then in addition to rotation of the joint, there is translation of the joint. That means there is horizontal displacement at the joints, which is called as sway. So in final moment, there is contribution of rotation as well as displacement. And hence, for such frames, in addition to rotation factor, which has been explained in earlier videos, we have to calculate displacement factors also. So welcome back to my channel to understand analysis of portal frame with sway using Carney's method. To understand this video in better way, you should have basic knowledge of Carney's method. The link is provided in description box in case you want to understand the method from basics. So in this video, we are going to study the procedure for analysis of portal frame subjected to sway, and also I will explain one numerical example using Carney's method. We know that Carney's method is derived from slope deflection method. 2 EI by L is called as rotation contribution and 6 EI delta upon L square is called as displacement contribution. So here in Carney's method, final moment is 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus fixed end moment. This displacement contribution is due to sway of the frame. So finally, MAB means final moment at A whose far end is B is equal to 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus fixed end moment. Now let us see what are the different steps in analysis of portal frame subjected to sway. To analyze the asymmetrical portal frame using Carney's method, the first step is to calculate fixed end moment and joint moment for the given load. After calculating fixed end moment and joint moments, we have to calculate rotation factor. To calculate rotation factor, we use this table. Joint member K is relative stiffness, summation k, and then rotation factor is minus half times k upon summation k. We know that rotation factor is minus half time distribution factor in moment distribution method. Once we calculate rotation factor, next step is to calculate displacement factor. So displacement factor is calculated only for columns and not for beams. Please remember this. Now how to calculate this displacement factor? For calculation of displacement factor, we use this type of table. So here in this table, it is member. K means relative stiffness. When far end is fixed, it is I by L. When far end is hinged, it is 3/4 I by L. Now let us see what is the meaning of C. C is reference height upon column height. Now what is mean by reference height and what is column height, that we will see while solving the problem. So in this method, we consider any one column as a reference column, and with respect to that, we have to calculate the value of C. Then we take C square, then we multiply K into C, then we calculate M. Now what is M? M is equal to 1 when column end is fixed. When the support of column is fixed, and M is taken as 3 by 4 when the support is hinged. So this is how we decide M. After calculating M, you have to take M into K into C square. Then add this MKC square, you will get summation of MKC square. And after that, we can calculate displacement factor, which is given by this formula, that is minus 3 by 2 kc means this column divided by summation kc square means addition of this column. So this is how we calculate displacement factor. We know that after calculating rotation factor, we check it by adding the rotation factor at joint. So we know that the sum of rotation factor at joint is minus 0.5. Similarly, after calculating displacement factor also, we check for displacement factor. So let us see how to check the displacement factor. So if there is a portal frame ABCD with column as AB and CD, then we take multiplication of this factor M, C and D of one column plus M, C and D of second column. D means displacement factor. So if you add this, you will get minus 1.5. So after calculating displacement factor using that table, we have to check whether you get minus 1.5 or not. We have two types of sway problems in Kanis method. One is when the frame is subjected to only vertical loads, and second is when the frame is subjected to horizontal load in addition to vertical load. So if there is horizontal load on the column, then let us see how to calculate the story moment. In Kanis method, when the frame is subjected to sway, in addition to rotation contribution, we have to calculate displacement contribution also. So if there is horizontal load on column, we have to add story moment while calculating displacement contribution. So story moment is given by QR into HR by 3. Now what is this QR and HR? To calculate story moment, there are again two cases when the load on column acts at the nodal point and when the load on the column acts anywhere along the length of the column. So first we will see the first case when the load is acting at nodal point. So while calculating story moment, if there is nodal point load on the column, then QR HR by 3, where QR is horizontal nodal point load on the column and HR is the height of that column. If the load is not at nodal point, then first of all you have to draw the free body diagram of column and calculate reaction at this top end. So to calculate the reaction, we have to draw the free body diagram like this. These moments are the fixed end moments due to this applied load. If you take summation of moment about this bottom support equal to zero, we can calculate this R. Once you calculate this R, then QR is equal to and opposite to this R value. So this QR, which we take in the calculation of sway moment, is equal and opposite to the reaction R. So support moment is QR HR divided by 3. So QR is equal and opposite to this reaction R. So this is how we can calculate QR if the load is not at the nodal point. One more thing we have to remember in case of sway analysis, that if there is hinge support, then while calculating C, when we calculate displacement factor, we have to calculate C. So while calculating C, the length of that column is taken as 1.5 times original length. This we will see while solving the problems. Now, once we calculate fixed end moments, rotation factor, displacement factor, and story moment, the next step is to calculate rotation contribution and displacement contribution. This is a very important step in Kanis method. Now suppose we want to analyze any unsymmetrical portal frame using Kanis method, then first of all we have to draw the basic sketch of Kanis method by drawing the two squares at the joints, which is explained in earlier videos. So here to solve this, let us see how we can write the various values we have calculated so far. So for that, first of all, we will make two squares at the joint B and C. Inside these squares, we will draw two small squares like this. And then we complete this frame. After completing frame, we write the fixed end moments. So where we write the fixed end moment? For this column, we write fixed end moment MFAB and MFBA on left side of that column. For beam, fixed end moment we write on top of that beam, and for this column to the right side of that column. Then after that, we have to write the rotation factor. Rotation factor we have to write near each member. So this is member BC. So we have to write here rotation factor BC. This is rotation factor BA. Similarly here CB and CD. So write the rotation factor inside this square. After that, you have to write the displacement factor which we have calculated. Displacement factors we have calculated for this column and this column. So we have to write the displacement factors here. After writing all these basic values, we have to carry out the rotation contribution and displacement contribution. Now let us see where we are going to write, which values we are going to write here and which values we are going to write here. So here we are going to write rotation contribution for member BA in this direction. Here we are going to write rotation contribution of member BC. Then here we are going to write rotation contribution for CB and here for rotation contribution for CD. After writing rotation contribution, we have to write displacement contribution. So displacement contribution we write below this line in this direction. Similarly here we write in this direction. So this is how we write all the basic values on this frame. So first of all these are calculated, and here we have to write the rotation contribution at joint B, here rotation contribution at joint C, and here displacement contribution for each column. Inside this small square, you have to take the summation of fixed end moment at that joint. So fixed end moment BA plus fixed end moment BC, you have to write here, and here fixed end moment CB and fixed end moment CD. Now after deciding the position where we are writing the rotation contribution and displacement contribution, let us see what are the different cycles in this Kani's method. So first of all, we start with this joint and we calculate rotation contribution at this joint. After that, we go to joint C, we calculate rotation contribution at joint C. Then we calculate displacement contribution for column AB, and then we calculate displacement contribution for column CD. So this is the sequence of each cycle. So in each cycle, what is the sequence? First, we calculate rotation contribution at joint B. Then we calculate rotation contribution at joint C. Then we calculate displacement contribution for column AB, and then we calculate displacement contribution at column CD. So this completes one cycle. Again, in next cycle, we follow same procedure. Now let us see how to calculate displacement contribution here and rotation contributions here. So let us see in next slide. Now let us see how will be the first cycle. So I have given some numbers here. One is displacement contribution, which we are going to write here for AB. Two is rotation contribution of BA. Three is for summation of fixed end moment. Four is rotation contribution at BC. Similarly, for joint CD, I have given the numbers. So first of all, we start with joint B and we calculate these values of rotation contribution at joint B. Now let us see how to calculate rotation contribution at joint B. To calculate rotation contribution at joint B, that means value at this second position and fourth position, what we do? We add this displacement contribution plus this summation of fixed end moment plus rotation contribution at far end. To this sum, we multiply by rotation factor right here and by this rotation factor right here. So what does it mean? Rotation contribution at any joint is equal to rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus sum of fixed end moment. To this, multiply by rotation factor, you will get rotation contribution. So this is how to calculate rotation contribution at joint B. Second stage, to calculate rotation contribution at joint C. That means to calculate values at place 5 and 7. How we calculate this? So rotation contribution is rotation contribution at far ends plus displacement contribution plus sum of fixed end moment multiplied by rotation factor. So here we add the sum of fixed end moment, then rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution, which is numbered 8. To this, multiply by rotation factor, write the rotation contribution. So this is how we calculate rotation contribution at B and then rotation contribution at C. Next is we have to calculate displacement contribution at 1 and 8. So how we calculate displacement contribution, that is the value at 1 and 8 position. So to calculate this displacement contribution, we have to calculate displacement contribution by multiplying the top value of the rotation contribution of that column, that is RCBA and RCCD, this top value multiply by C of that column. What is C? C is reference height upon column height, which we calculate while calculating displacement factor. So these two value multiplied by C value of column AB plus this top value multiplied by C value of column CD, if there is sway moment, then you have to add this moment. To this, you have to multiply by displacement factor to get displacement contribution at respective places. So in each cycle, we have to calculate the values at three places. One is rotation contribution at joint B, second is rotation contribution at joint C, and third is displacement contribution. And this is the way by which we can calculate all these values. Let me again repeat again this, that displacement contribution is rotation contribution at top of the column multiplied by C of this column plus rotation contribution at top of this column multiplied by C of this column plus sway moment, and to this multiply by displacement factor right here and then displacement factor right here. This completes first cycle. After this, repeat these cycles at all the joints till you get same value of rotation contribution and displacement contribution at all the places, and then stop these cycles. After completing this, we have to calculate the final moments. To calculate the final moment, we use this formula. So final moment at any joint is equal to 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus fixed end moment. Now remember that while calculating column final moment, we will need this displacement contribution. But while calculating beam moments, displacement contribution will not be there. So this is how we solve the portal frame subjected to sway using Kani's method. Now we will solve one numerical example. Let us consider this frame which is subjected to nodal point load of 80 kN as shown in the figure, with both the supports as fixed support and with different values of flexural rigidity as shown in this figure. So let us see how we can solve this frame using Kani's method. Now first step is to calculate the fixed end moments. Now in this case, load is acting at the nodal point, and we know that fixed end moments are not developed due to nodal point load, and therefore all fixed end moments are zero in this case. Now since there is horizontal load on the column, next step is to calculate the story moment. But if there is only vertical load on this portal frame, then we don't have to calculate the story moment. So let us see how to calculate story moment in this case. So we know that QR is the nodal point load, which is 80 kN. Now the story moment is calculated using this formula QR HR by 3, where QR is 80 kN and HR is the height of this column, which is 6 meter. So we get 160 kN meter. So this is how to calculate story moment. After calculating fixed end moment and story moment, next step is to calculate rotation factor. Now rotation factor we calculate using this tabular form. So there are two joints B and C. So joint member K, summation K, and then rotation factor. So first we consider joint B. At joint B, there are two members BA and BC, and since the ends are fixed and this is continuous, then K is equal to I by L. So here I is 2I, 2I by 6 and I by 4. So if you calculate this, you will get rotation factor as minus 0.29 and minus 0.21 at joint B. Now remember that after calculating the rotation factor, you check whether the summation of rotation factor at the joint is equal to minus 0.5 or not. After calculating rotation factor at joint B, calculate rotation factor at joint C. There are again two members. In similar way, you calculate rotation factor, calculate the relative stiffness, then summation of relative stiffness, and then calculate rotation factor and check whether the addition of rotation factor is minus 0.5 or not. So in this case, it is minus 0.2 and minus 0.3, which is equal to minus 0.5. Now next step is to calculate displacement factors. Now displacement factor is calculated only for columns. Now in this case, there are two columns, that is column AB and column CD. So we have to calculate two displacement factors. So displacement factors we calculate using this tabular form. So here there is member K, then C, C square, K into C. We have seen this, how is the table. Then in this, we have to write this C. Now let us see first what is C. We know that K is equal to relative stiffness. So members are AB and CD. Two members are there, that is columns. And K are the relative stiffness. Now what is C? C is reference height upon column height. Now let us see first how to calculate C. So to calculate C, we have to consider one of the column as reference column. So in this case, we are considering AB as reference column. So if AB is reference column, then C for column AB is equal to reference height is 6 meter divided by column height is also 6 meter. So C for column AB is 1. Now we will calculate C for column CD. C for column CD is reference height, which is height of column AB, that is 6, divided by height of this column CD, 4, we get C for column CD. So this is how we calculate C value. Now let us complete this table. Now to take the M value depends on the end condition of the column. If the column is fixed, then M is 1, and if the column is hinged, then M is 3 by 4. Since in our case, both the columns are fixed, then value of M is equal to 1 in this case. Now let us see how to write this table. In this member column, we have to write two columns, AB and CD. K value we have already calculated while calculating rotation contribution. So here you have to take that value from that table, 0.33 and 0.375. C value, just now I have explained how to calculate C value, that is reference column height divided by the column height of that column. Then calculate C square, take multiplication of K into C. M is equal to 1 since the both the column ends are fixed, M is 1. Complete this, then take summation of this, which is 1.17, and after this you will calculate displacement factor using this formula. So if you use this formula for column AB, displacement factor is minus 0.42, and for column CD, displacement factor is minus 0.72. After calculating displacement factor, we have to check whether these calculated displacement factors are correct or not. So now next step is check for displacement factor. To check the displacement factors, we have to use this formula, MAB CAB displacement factor of AB. What is MAB? Is this M value. CAB is this value multiplied by displacement factor of AB, that is minus 0.42, plus same for column CD. M value of column CD is 1, C value of column CD is 1.5, multiplied by, here it should be minus 0.72. So if you calculate this, so you will get minus 1.5. So if you get minus 1.5, that means the calculated displacement factors are correct. Now next is to make this sketch. So on this sketch, you have to write this rotation factors, minus 0.29 and minus 0.21, which we have already calculated. And here rotation contribution at joint C, minus 0.2 and minus 0.3. After that, we know that fixed end moments are zero. So we have written fixed end moment zero. Here also fixed end moments are zeros. I have not written zero moments here, but these moments are also zero. And these are the displacement factor for column AB and column CD. Once you write these initial values, next is to start the cycle. So at first cycle, we start with joint B and we calculate values at 2 and 4. So how we calculate values at 2 and 4? These values are called as rotation contribution. So rotation contribution at joint B is equal to this first value plus this value plus this value. What does it mean? Rotation contribution at far end plus displacement contribution plus sum of the fixed end moment. To this, you have to multiply by rotation factor right here. Multiply by this rotation factor right here. So initially, we don't have any value, so we have to write the 0 at 5 and at this location 1. Okay. Then rotation contribution at this far end is always 0. Therefore, I have not included in this case. Next is, after completing calculation at 2 and 4 place, next go to joint C. Calculate rotation contribution at joint C. So at joint C, what you have to add? Rotation contribution at far end. Rotation contribution at far end means at this end and at this end. At this end, there is always zero. Therefore, I have not included in this table, in this bracket. So far end rotation contribution plus sum of fixed end moment plus displacement contribution. Add this, multiply by rotation factor, that is minus 0.2 and minus 0.3. You will get values at 5 and 7. After that, we calculate displacement factor at 1 and 8. Now, how to calculate displacement factor? Displacement factor is this 2 value multiply by C of this column, 7 value multiply by C of this column, plus story moment. To this, multiply by 0.42 right at this one location, multiply by 0.72 right at this 8th location. So this completes first cycle. After completion of first cycle, in this case, we will have 0 values here because initially no values are there of fixed end moment. These are zeros and 0 here. But first value we will get here and here. Once you get these values in second cycle at joint B, add these values, far end values, and then multiply by rotation factor right below this. Then go to joint C, repeat the process, and again then calculate displacement contribution here. Likewise, you have to complete all the cycles till you get same values in consecutive cycles. Now let us understand the first cycle. In first cycle, first we go to joint B and we calculate rotation contribution at B. Now to calculate rotation contribution at B, first of all, we have to add 1, 3 and 5 location values. So here there is no value initially, we have to take 0. This is also 0 and this is also 0. So we get rotation contribution at joint B is equal to 0. Similarly, when we go to joint C, we have to add 4, 6 and 8 values. So these values are also 0. Therefore, we will get rotation contribution at joint C is equal to 0. Next is to calculate the displacement contribution for column AB and CD. Before we start calculating displacement contribution, first of all, we will write what is the value of C for column AB. It is 1. What is the value of C for column CD? It is 1.5. This we have taken from the table of displacement contribution, displacement factor. Then we have calculated sway moment, story moment, which is 160. So we will write here. So I want values at one place and at place, which is called as displacement contribution. Now what is displacement contribution? It is the value at 2 multiplied by C plus value at 7 multiplied by C plus M. To this bracket, you have to multiply by displacement factor and write here and here. That means 0 multiplied by 1 plus 0 multiplied by 1.5 plus 160. To this, multiply by 0.42 right here. Multiply by 0.72 right here. So let us calculate it. And so zero plus zero plus 160 multiply by minus 0.42, you will get minus 67.2. So this is displacement contribution at column AB. In same way, if you calculate 160 multiply by minus 0.72, we get minus 115.2. So this completes first cycle. Now let us calculate second values in second cycle. Now in second cycle, we will again go to first joint B. At joint B, we will calculate rotation contribution by adding values at places 1, 3 and 5. That means this 1, 3 and 5. At 3 and 5, there are 0. So at 1, it is minus 67.2 is the new value. So first of all, we will cut the initial values. Then minus 67.2 multiply by these respective rotation factors, we will get values here. So those values will be the rotation contribution in second cycle. So if you calculate this, you will get 19.49 and 14.11 as rotation contribution at joint B. Next is go to joint C and again calculate rotation contribution at joint C. So rotation contribution at joint C is 4 plus 6 plus 8. 4 means this value, new value. 6 is 0 and 8 is this new value. So add this 14.11 minus 115.2 plus 0 multiplied by 0.2 right here, multiplied by minus 0.3 right here. So we will get rotation contribution at joint C. So if you add 14.11 plus 0 minus 115.2 multiplied by rotation factor at respective point, you will get 20.22 and 30.33 as rotation contribution at joint C. After calculating rotation contribution, again calculate displacement contribution. To calculate the displacement contribution for column AB, first cut the initial value, and then displacement contribution is this top value of the column, that is 19.49 multiplied by C plus 30.33 multiplied by 1.5 plus 160. So this is this bracket, top value multiplied by C, top value for CD multiplied by C for CD plus M. So that means 19.49 into 1 plus 30.33 into 1.5 plus 160. To this multiply by minus 0.42 right here. So you will get minus 94.49 as displacement factor, displacement contribution, new value at the displacement contribution for AB. Similarly, we can calculate displacement contribution for CD. So displacement contribution at CD means 19.49 into 1 plus 30.33 into 1.5 plus 160 multiply by minus 0.72, we get new value minus 161.9. So this completes second cycle. So in each cycle, we have to calculate two values as rotation contribution at joint B, two values as rotation contribution at joint C, first at joint B and then at joint C, and then displacement contribution for column AB and then for column CD. So this completes a one cycle. So we have to repeat this till we get these values, same values in next cycle. So we will repeat this cycle till we get the same values. So after few cycles, we get finally the rotation contribution at joint B for BA as 21.57, for BC as 15.62, for CB 34, and for CD 51.01. These are the rotation contributions, and displacement contribution for column AB is minus 108.4, and for column CD is, here it should be minus 185.82. So these are the final values of rotation contribution and displacement contribution. Once you calculate this, then last step is to calculate the final end moments. Now to get the final moment for columns, that is column AB and column CD, we use this formula, that is for MAB and MBA, MCD and MDC, we use 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus far end plus displacement contribution plus fixed end moment. Then while calculating final moment for beam, there will not be any displacement contribution. There will be only rotation contribution plus fixed end moment. So let us calculate final moments. So final moment we calculate using this formula. For column AB, 2 times rotation contribution at near end is 0 plus far end value plus displacement contribution, and fixed end moment is 0. Therefore, this is the final value. Similarly for BA, so these are the values for column AB. So if you calculate this, this is at near end, this is at far end, this is displacement contribution, fixed end moment is 0. So we get finally, this is the final moment MBA. Then for beam BC, 2 times rotation contribution at near end plus far end, there will not be any displacement contribution and fixed end moment is 0, and therefore we get 65.24. Actually, we must get same value, equal and opposite sign here, because summation of moment at joint B must be 0. But here it is 0.26, here it is 0.24. You may get some difference. So in that case, you can take average value while drawing the bending moment diagram. So in this case, we can take 65.25 while drawing the bending moment diagram. Next, we calculate for beam at other end C. So we get 83.62 in same way. Then for column CD, again these values must be same. So you can take average of this 2, that is 83.7 as the joint moment at C. And then finally, we get the value at D, that is minus 134.81. This is how we calculate final moment. Once you calculate the moment, the last step is to draw the bending moment diagram. So this was the given frame, and this is how the bending moment diagram look like. So here, instead of writing two different values, you can write the average value similarly here. And if you have any doubt in how to draw the bending moment diagram of frame, then you can watch my video on how to draw the bending moment diagram of frame. In next video, we will solve one example on the portal frame subjected to sway, but load is not at nodal point, but it will be somewhere along the height, and also with portal frame with vertical loads. If you have any doubt about this video, you can write in the comment box. Do watch the other videos on my channel to understand the concept of structural analysis. So stay connected. Thank you for watching this video.